Hi, it's me again with CorelDraw Tips and Tricks, part two. Luckily, I did not erase this file that I worked on yesterday, and I actually took the background. If you didn't watch that, we got rid of these lines that you can see. And somebody asked how I drew that. Well, I did not draw that, but I think I've got it figured out. And it looks so much better like this than... like this. I mean, at an angle, it really looks good. So we're going to draw it like this. So I'm going to take a, you know what? I'm going to work in the center of the page too. Let me move this out of the way. Shouldn't really matter, but I'm going to draw a square holding down the control button. I'm going to go ahead and rotate it 45 degrees. And then I'm going to take it and I'm going to control D and make a duplicate. While holding on the control button, I'm going to bring this down. Then I'm going to take a 2-point line, holding down the control button, because I want this to stop the leak when I fill this in. And then I'm going to make a duplicate of it and put it over there. And I could do that another way, just to give you a little bit of insight. Let's take this line away. And let's group these together and let's hit P. Now let's take this and hit P and select them both and hit L. It put it right where it needed to be. Now let's make a duplicate of that, Control D. Hold down the shift to select that and hit R. And now it put it on the right. So now what we're gonna do is take away this line and we're gonna use the Smart Fill tool. And I'm going to use the same colors and I'm just going to fill in those spots. Now, what I should have done before I started that, and I always try to do this, Control G to group it. That way, in just a second, I can get rid of my outline. So I can just move this, grab this, and move it out of the way. So now I just have this. I'm going to grab the inside. I'm going to get the interactive fill tool. And I'm gonna go upwardly and put black. And I just happen to be using the same color he did. And that looks pretty good. Then I can grab this, grab that one. Let me zoom in here. Grab that one, interactive fill tool, and this time go down and put a little darkness on that edge. Now, we should be able to copy the fill exactly, but it doesn't really matter. We're just going to use the interactive fill tool and just kind of do the same thing. I'm a little bit off angle, but you can always bring this back and bring this over and maybe bring that up. Then just kind of back off of it and look. Mine's a little bit darker. So let's do that. Let's copy the fill and see if it works. Let's... select that, go up to edit, copy properties from, fill, and then check our property. And it did exactly the same thing. Now let's group this together, Control G. Now I made one mistake. I hope I moved that out. I hope I nudged it, but I didn't. I should have nudged it. Let's put this right back because I need to rotate from here. So I'm going to Control D and duplicate. I'm going to double click on it and move that center rotation to there. And now I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. Control D, Control D. And then I think all he did, well, he didn't have, I don't know that his original drawing had black, but we're going to use the Smart Fill tool set on black and you could put any color, but that's a pretty cool design. I like it. I mean, there's multiple things you could do. If I was to do it again, I would make my square smaller. It kind of looks like it's something holding a black square in a way, wrapped around. Anyway, I hope that answered their question and thank you for watching.